Hello, everyone. Thank you guys so much for joining us for another week's My Expert Live Training webinar. My name is Jared, and we're going to have some fun today. But today, this is something kind of, you know, geared more towards small businesses. And so today, I'm talking about the top five easiest upsells for your small business. So I'm not going to pretend like I have this big, huge, booming business. I work here at Heat Press Nation, which is a big booming business. But like me personally, like my t-shirt line, I do work on the side. I've actually switched from advertising my print business, which I do run on the side. So right now I'm currently word of mouth only and return customers, which is a good place for me because I got a full-time job. Like I know a lot of you have, a lot of you guys, you have your full-time jobs and you're wanting to supplement your income with a side business. So you and me, we're on the same page here. I love my job here at Heat Press Nation, but who doesn't like a little extra money doing something fun like pressing t-shirts, hats and mugs and all that cool stuff. So that's what we're gonna talk about today. Today I'm gonna share with you the five best and easiest upsells for your small business. And this isn't just from me. These are some business friends, a lot of feedback that I've gotten from my customers over the years, a lot of you guys in the group. These are the five easiest upsells. Now some of them are really profitable. Some of them, they're just easy. And sometimes when you're like me, you know, this might not be your full-time job yet. You're just kind of going for the easy money. You know, you just kind of want to have that, hey, how can I get an extra 50 bucks, 100 bucks? How can I get an extra couple hundred bucks out of this order? So, as a lot of you guys know, acquiring your customers, that's probably the hardest part, is getting new customers, am I right? So once you do get the customers, how do you get the most out of the order? So that's what upsells are. An upsell is like when you go to McDonald's, you know, you see the combo is like $8.99, and then they ask you, hey, would you like to supersize it for an extra, or they used to, I don't know if they, because then they had that documentary, and it was crazy. But anyways, they used to ask you, hey, for an extra 79 cents, do you want to supersize it? So you go from a medium fry to this gigantic, you know, side of fries and your regular drink to a gigantic drink. And they would make it extra 79 cents. Now, McDonald's, it only cost them like an extra, like, I think it was like 5 or 10 cents to actually, like, that's how much money they lost in the cost of fries and soda. But for every meal that supersized, they would make like anywhere from an extra 50 to 70 cents. You multiply that by every location gets hundreds and hundreds, sometimes even thousands of orders a day. So you multiply those 50, let's say it was 50 cents by 1,000. Well, that's like a lot of dollars. I'm not great at the head math. I think it's like $500 or something like that. You know, 50 cents times 1,000. And trust me, McDonald's, a lot of locations get way more than 1,000 orders a day, believe it or not. So the point there is, it's an upsell. It's just an easy transition to say, hey, I'm about to make $100 off this order. Why don't I sweeten that up a bit and make $140 off this order, $120? Is it possible to double the order value? That's what an upsell is. So the first one, and I want to make sure that I do this right, I actually have two. So, and we're going by setup here. Not everybody has the same setup. Some people have sublimation printers. Some people have, you're using HTV, you know, heat transfer vinyl. You got a heat press and a vinyl cutter. So my first, and I'm going to pair them together. So we have five today. The first two, easiest upsells. And these are for folks who have a heat press and a vinyl cutter. Or even if you're pre-ordering your transfers, maybe you're getting them from like FM Expressions, Supercolor, whatever. You know, you could still do this. As long as you have a heat press, these are the two easiest upsells for you. And I'm going to bring them on screen here. The two easiest are going to be an additional location and an alternate product. And I'll tell you what I mean. So we're looking at the construction gentleman on the left. And you see, and of course, these are just mock-ups, right? You know, most people are, they're going to want a logo on the chest of the garment. So you see, you know, your customer's graphic here. But then look at his right bicep, our left. You see, we got a second hit on that sleeve. Now, an additional I'll tell you how I charge my customers, right? There's the base price of the t-shirt. So 100% cotton t-shirt, one color, one location, meaning that one color in one location is usually the chest or the back of the garment. One color meaning I'm only going to print one color, right? Now, if they want an additional location or color, there's an additional fee. You're going to want to have your profits built into each and every location. So for example, my base price for a single shirt. Now, as people start ordering in bulk, you want to give them discounts. But if someone comes to me and says, hey, I need 10 shirts. For me, that's very common. I work a lot with a lot of small businesses. I have personally networked with a lot of small businesses over the years in this job and in previous jobs. Also, with my, my dad's a pastor, I work at my church, and I've developed a network through there of other churches, other small businesses, people anyways. So a lot of my bread and butter for my side hustle is small businesses. Very like a really common order for me is, hey, I need 10 t-shirts. Cool. 10 t-shirts. And so usually I tell them, okay, well, for 10 t-shirts, my base price, $12 a shirt. Of course, that's higher than a screen printer, right? Or for some of you guys, I'm like, oh my gosh, it's so low. My base price for 10 t-shirts, and I get this all the time, is $12 a t-shirt, one location, one color. Every additional location or color is an additional, and depending on how much I like the person, it's an additional $3. So every additional location and color is $3, unless it's like a really complicated logo, in which case I just outsource my transfers. So whatever, right? An additional location, so per color, per location is an additional $3. So if someone wants two colors on the front, $12 base, additional color, single location is $3. And that's a great way to just add an extra money because I make, more money on that. If they want on the sleeve, that's an additional location. So that's an additional $3. Now, it doesn't sound like a lot, but this t-shirt, and we're going to go back to it. So if this is $12 for the t-shirt, well, now it's a $15 t-shirt. I just added a tiny little logo right here. And what's cool about sleeve is that it's not a lot of material. I can get a ton of these little sleeve transfers from the same amount of material it takes for a chest transfer. So I love sleeve transfers or pocket logos, which, I don't know if you could see my mouse. It goes right about here. So additional locations are super easy way to make a good, is to upsell. It's the easiest upsell. And it looks really cool too. The second thing is an alternate product. Now, this is great if someone orders something like you see on screen right there. These are yellow. These are very yellow t-shirts. You're probably not going to have that on hand. So if you already have to place an order with your t-shirt wholesaler, you're already paying for shipping. You may as well upsell your customer on an alternate product like this hoodie. Because the hoodies, now these hoodies, so for me, I usually charge $25 for a hoodie, basic, like you see on screen, basic hoodie, one color, one location. All right, $25 easy. Some of you guys are charging 30. Some of you guys are even charging up to 35 or 40 for multiple stuff, whatever, right? If someone's ordering 10 of anything, I will lower my price. So what I'll often like, hey, those shirts you have are cool. And for example, so we have like some construction guys. I'm assuming they're construction. These are just models. So if someone was ordering something like this, I would say, hey, do you want a couple of extra hoodies? I can get you a great deal on a few extra hoodies. They say, well, how much? Well, $25. And $25 for a custom hoodie, think about it. And I commented this in our Facebook group the other day. At Target, you're paying about $25 for a blank hoodie anyways. At Target. So for a custom hoodie, of course, you're going to pay more. Me, I might be undercharging. Oh, well, I'll tell them, I'm like, hey, if you want to add a couple hoodies, I can get them to you for $25 a pop. Really? And usually the response is people who know how much things cost, like, oh, that's cool. Yeah, give me three. And in case you guys didn't know, these hoodies, the blanks cost about $9. And then the vinyl, I'm going to use maybe $2 worth of vinyl. So the profit on the hoodie is actually way more than the profit on the t-shirt, even though the work is the same. It's the same amount of work, whether you're heat pressing onto the hoodie or the t-shirt. The only difference is hoodies, since it's a more valuable product, your markup is higher. So you get a better profit margin. So yeah, an alternate product, especially if you already have to pay the shipping from your t-shirt wholesaler, an alternate product like a hoodie is so easy. And then again, hoodies are the exact same amount of work as t-shirts. So I try to push hoodies all day right now. It's winter time, it's cold. You guys should be pushing hoodies as much as possible. Again, it's the same amount of work. You're weeding the same graphic. The process for a hoodie on a heat press is exactly the same. You're gonna put it on just like a t-shirt. You're gonna heat press it just like a t-shirt. And it takes the exact same amount of time as a t-shirt. Again, hoodies, because there's more perceived value there, there is more value there, the markup's higher. Pretty cool, right? Okay, so those are my first two. Again, the first two, and they were on screen forever, but I don't care. Additional location and alternate product. Those are two of the easiest. Those are two of the easiest upsells if you have a regular heat press. You got a heat press, you got a vinyl cutter, or maybe you have just a heat press and you're ordering your transfers from one of these, from, again, like FM Expressions or Supercolor is really popular right now. You know, you're ordering your transfers from them. Extra product. Anyways, those are two of the easiest if you have a regular heat press. Now, if you have a cap press, all right, and I love cap presses, depending on where you're at, of course. I wish I sold more caps than I do. When I bought my cap press, I had an order for about 2 dozen hats, and it almost paid for my cap press, the first order. So I was like, oh, cool. Of course, I still had to pay some. I bought my cap press, fulfilled the order, and then I was like, oh, dude, I'm going to be. So I wish I sold more hats than I do. People, it's SoCal. It's Southern California. Everybody loves hats, especially dad hats, right? I don't push them as much. I really should. Now, I need to take my own advice for this one and push the dad caps more. All right? But for my second easiest, dad hats all day. Now, when I say I don't sell as many, I mean like per job. Like not everybody wants hats. But for the people who do want hats, oh my gosh, they love them. They absolutely love them. And here's why I love dad hats, all right? Dad hats, I sell them for, I usually get about $12 a hat minimum. And they actually cost less to produce than a t-shirt. So you're getting at least as much as you would for a t-shirt, usually sometimes more. And it's actually more affordable to produce. The only thing you need is a cap press. So the profit margins on especially these dad hats are so easy. I love, and I'm wearing one right now. Actually, let's show you guys. So this is mine, right? Unstructured, and part, my hair is all messy, right? I have major hat hair. Unstructured, 100% cotton. When I say unstructured, it means the crown. It's just, there's no hardness to it. A structured cap is a lot of the baseball hats or whatever, the snapbacks. The crown, which is this part right here, is structured, meaning that it's kind of firm. You might have to stuff your hat press. Maybe you've fallen into that, whatever, right? These unstructured dad caps are super popular right now, and I love them because they're so easy to heat press. Check this out, one color, all right? So for my one color, one location, and you could get creative. You could press like the side right here if you want to add an extra location. Going back to the extra location is very cool. Also, you could use your hat press. It's a lot easier to press the sleeves on a hat press than it is on your big heat press, all right? Hat presses are dope. So if you have a hat press, get a bunch of these. These hats, I think, cost like either $1.87 or $2.87. They're under $3. They're literally the same cost. I want to say it's $1.87. I'm not sure. They're the same cost as my t-shirts, all right? And again, you should not sell them for any less than a t-shirt. In fact, $12 is my low end. Sometimes I'm charging $15 or more if it's like a one-off. Depends on the quantity, right? But hats are great. Not only are they a great upsell item, so someone's ordering a bunch of t-shirts. Hey, I have some hats laying around. Would you want your graphic on a hat? I can get you a great deal on them. Boom, that easy. And now you've just added. So maybe they weren't going to buy any more t-shirts. Like, no, I only need 10 t-shirts. Do you want some hats to go with that? So you're not going to sell them any more t-shirts, but you probably are going to be able to sell them on a half dozen hats. Hats are a great upsell. So if you have a cat press, every order you should be pitching your customers, hey, and keep these on hand. I usually have about a half dozen of these at any given moment for any of my t-shirt customers. Hey, by the way, did you want some hats? Dad hats all day. And that's if you have a hat press. Now, if you have sublimation, all right, don't worry, I didn't forget about all you sublimation friends. These are the final two. Again, we have five of our easiest upsells: alternate product and face masks. Okay, alternate product, what is that? All right, so let's focus our attention to the coffee mug on the left. Oh, by the way, it's sublimation. Of course, you guys know you can put as many colors as you want. If you have a mug press, all right, and this is for all of you guys, my friends, if you have a coffee mug press and you're bored of coffee mugs, what? Bored of coffee mugs? If your plain white mugs are getting a little boring, maybe you have repeat customers and you've already sold them coffee mugs. There's lots of different options. One of my favorites, and we're gonna go back already. Look at this mug right here. It has the blue rim. I'm sorry, has the blue inside and handle. These are available at heatpressnation.com. I love these. You know, I always have a stock of blank white mugs, 11 ounce, and now I have a stock of 11 ounce with the black inside and handle. I chose black because it's just really popular. It looks cool with pretty much anything. But you could special order pretty much any of these colors. I mean, there's a bunch. If you go on our website, heatpressnation.com, you could check out our sublimation blanks. We have the blue, red, orange, lots of basically the primary colors are available. And it just looks so much cooler to have the colored handle and the inside of the mug. I wish I had one on hand to show you, but I don't. At home, so now I carry a stock of 11 ounce mugs just because those are easy. And now I started to carry the black handle and inside. It's a great upsell because now they do cost more. Okay, let's get that out of the way. They do cost more, but you can charge more. So don't just charge more to cover your cost. Charge more to cover your cost and an additional margin. It's worth it, especially if your customers, they're already used to the white mugs. Looks a little boring. Maybe they just have a basic logo and they want to spice it up, make a cooler looking mug. Those colored rim and handles, and not only those ones, not pictured, we have these frosted beer steins, which are cool as heck. There's these frosted mugs. Father's Day will be here before you know it. So get those fast, but it's a great thing to offer, especially if your business, maybe you're making t-shirts for a restaurant, you're making t-shirts for a bar, making t-shirts for anyone. And in this pandemic, lots of restaurants are looking for other ways besides food to generate income. So hit up the popular spots in your area, maybe work out a deal with them. And they might not be interested in like plain coffee mugs, but they might be pretty impressed with those frosted glass steins, which again are very cool. Or you could just switch it up a little bit, like you saw in the picture, the colored handle and inside. And by the way, if you have both, like me, I have t-shirt equipment, I have a vinyl cutter, I'm still running the Cameo 3, and I have an SG400. I've had my stuff for a little while. If I'm making t-shirts for somebody and I have mug equipment and I have hat equipment, I'm gonna offer them the whole kitchen sink. I'm gonna be like, hey, you want these t-shirts? If you'd like some mugs, let me know. I'll get you these mugs. If you want some hats, you know, mock it up for them. It takes just a few seconds online. Lots of great websites, all the mockups you see today. Now, they're not paying me to promote them, so I don't wanna give them too much, you know, light, but placeit.net, great place. I do all my mockups there now because it's so darn fast and so easy. So it takes a few seconds, mock it up for them, be like, hey, by the way, if you guys want some coffee mugs, boom, 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 boom. Work your magic. The last easiest upsell today, if you have sublimation equipment and you have a heat press, like a flat heat press, you're gonna wanna offer face masks. Now I know lots of controversy, unfortunately, over face masks, but the fact of the matter is there's a lot of places where not only are they required now, but they're going to be required for a little while. And I know there's some states, some places, some restaurants, some counties that don't require face masks. You probably hate face masks. I hate face masks for goodness sake, but they're not going to let me into the restaurant or the grocery store without it here in California. And what's cool about California is there's like millions upon millions upon millions of people here. So even if you're not in California, even if your state doesn't require masks, as long as the big states or the big cities are requiring masks, as long as Disney World is requiring face masks are going to be good business. And they're so easy to make. So easy. Once you have your template set up, which we have tutorials on that, by the way. We have Photoshop tutorials, how to create a template for any face mask. Once you have your template set up, you don't have to worry. It's just so easy. You just drag the customer's logo in there, you drop it in, you heat press the mask, bada bing, bada boom. So easy. So that's the last one, the Sublimation face mask. You could be full color. It could be anything, anything. And then you might even want to tell them like, hey, by the way, it doesn't have to be your company logo. You just want some face masks. Let me know. I've made spidery, flamey, other face, you know, face masks. They're just, you know, everybody's kind of sick of them. I know I'm sick. So I got a bag of like 100 of these and my voice is probably going to be muffled. I hate these masks, but I wear them. And I have some custom masks that I've made that are really cool. I like those ones. I like looking, especially if I'm going to go out to the grocery store where everybody's, you know, all of our faces are covered. You can't really see if I'm smiling or not. So I like putting fun stuff on my face masks. I can't say that word. I like putting fun stuff on my face mask. So you might just offer them like, hey, by the way, you want some face mask? Boom. And they're just so easy to make. Profit margins are there. It's worth it. And it's easy. Sometimes, yeah, I could get a better margin on other products, but sometimes, especially again, I got my day job. All right. So all this stuff I'm doing, I just need something easy to increase my revenue per order. That's really where it comes down to. Because if you're making an extra 20, 50 bucks per order, after 10 orders, you've made an extra $200 to $500. You know, and after, you know, at the end of the year, you're like, hey, with just these upsell items, I've actually made a few extra $1,000. And that's the name of the game. If you think, going back to the McDonald's angle, McDonald's, a billion-dollar company, you think they care about your 79 cents? They don't. They don't care about your 79 cents, but they care about their millions of customers' collective 79 cents. If it works for McDonald's, it should work for us too on the small business level. So I want to encourage you. We're going to go through, again, really quick here. Our first, number one, we're going to go back through the top five easiest upsells for your small business. An additional location. You see here on the left, not only do we have the main chest graphic, but we also have a sleeve hit, which took this shirt. Again, at the bare minimum, you should not be charging anything less than like $12 if they're ordering like 10 of them in quantity. But you know, you do whatever you want to do. But this went from a $12 to a $15 t-shirt. If somebody's only ordering just one, this actually goes, you know, the prices increase. If someone's ordering just one shirt from me, I start at like $18. It was like an $18 chest and then an additional $5 for the sleeve. So it went from $18 to a $23 t-shirt. Alternate product, this hoodie. Again, if they're ordering like 10, I'll give it to them for maybe like 25. I really try not to dip under that number, but if they're friends, I might even go down at like 20, 22. Anyways, if someone's ordering just one, charge those dudes like $35, man. Again, if Target can charge $25 for a plain blank hoodie, you can add way more to that for a custom one. Please don't forget that. So anyways, additional location, number one, alternate product, number two, dad hats all day. So if you have a hat press, you definitely want to be offering these upsells all day. That's number three. For all of our sublimation friends, consider alternate products, especially if you have a mug press. It's not just the plain white coffee mugs. Go to our website, heatpressnation.com, and check out the additional products that we have available. Very cool, and it does allow you to increase the like what you're charging your customers so you can make more per order. And then lastly, face masks. We have awesome blank face mask at heatpressnation.com. So you definitely want to check that out. And yeah, and they're just, again, I love them because they're so darn easy. All right, here's the last two tips that I do want to share with you. I don't know if the name Jordan Belfort rings a bell with you, all right? Maybe you may have heard of The Wolf of Wall Street. Now, please, that dude is a criminal, all right? But he didn't know a thing or two about selling. There's an interview of him. It's like a radio interview or a podcast that's making its rounds on the social media, especially if you're following some of the entrepreneur channels, right? It's on YouTube. You can look it up. Anyways, so this guy, of course, he eventually got out of prison and, you know, whatever, right? But he's telling his story of when he first started in sales. But Jordan Belfort, he started off selling meat and seafood door to door. Door to door meat. Okay, that wouldn't happen here in 2021. But back, I think this was like, the 80s or something like that. Anyways, he doesn't say when it was, but when he first getting started. And so Jordan Belfort, he goes door to door. And instead of knocking at the door and saying, hey, I'm Jordan, I sell meat. People close the door in his face, right? He goes on to tell a story that instead he changed his pitch. And his pitch was, hey, I'm Jordan. I deliver meat and seafood to some of your neighbors. I got a few extra boxes on the truck. And if you want, I'll give them to you at cost. That sounds a heck of a lot more appealing. I encourage you to check out his interview. It's really interesting. But it's all about your angle. You got to learn to pitch a little different. So instead of telling your friends, would you like an additional sleeve hit for $5? No, you don't want to tell them that because they're going to say, why do I need a sleeve hit? For an extra $5, you're just trying to milk me, man. You're just trying to get some money out of me. No. They're not going to go for that. So instead of like, oh, would you like an additional sleeve hit for $5? No, you're not going to pitch it to them. You're going to be like, dude, check out this mock-up. I mocked up how your logo would look on the sleeve, and I think it looks pretty cool, man. Don't even tell them how much it is at first. Get them to buy into the idea. That's where you're going to make your upsells. And then he's like, oh, dude, that's cool. How much is it? Dude, it's just $5, man. Actually, if you want to add the sleeve hit, I'll take 5% off your order. I'll take 10% off your order. More on that in a second. That's where the mock-ups are really helpful. Placeit.net, I think they charge like $80 a year. I don't know what it is, but it's worth it. All the time that I save making mock-ups. Now, if you're really great at Photoshop, make your own mock-ups. I don't care. Do whatever you want. Anyways, mock it up for them. And it doesn't have to be a super cool mock-up like you saw on screen right now. It could be anything. Mock it up and like, dude, I mocked up your graphic on this hoodie and I think it looks dope, man. Send it over to them. Oh, dude, and get them all pumped up on the product. Dude, that's sick. How much is that? And now they're asking you how much it is because they're interested in what you have to offer them. So mock-ups, they really go a long way in pitching upsells to your customers. Another thing you can say, kind of like what Jordan Belfort, the Wolf of Wall Street guy, was saying is like, hey, by the way, I have a few dozen extra face masks laying around from a job that canceled on me. If you want, I'll give you a really good deal on them. Many people need face masks right now, especially businesses. Lots of businesses are still using face masks. Which brings me to my last point that I'm going to say about upselling is your price can always go down, but it's really hard to get it to go back up. What I mean by that is when someone asks you for a quote them full price, quote them your full price, the money that you would ideally like to make, even if it seems a little high. Now, what that does is it gives you a little bit of wiggle room and it makes people think that, hey, they're getting a great deal, which they are, by the way. You should be pricing fair, not like you're not gouging anybody, right? But get always when people ask for a quote, give them the full price. If they say something like, oh, you know, that's a little steep for me, then you can come in and you could be your friend. It's like you're like your own good cop, bad cop. Bad cop sends them the invoice for the full price or the quote. Good cop says, well, let's work it out. Maybe I can get your discount, 10% discount. Actually, you're only ordering 4 t-shirts. If you wanted to order a half dozen, I could bring it down 10% per shirt. You know, so you're kind of using it as a negotiation tool now. So again, your pricing, always start at full price. And let them know. I always let my customers know, hey, if you want one shirt, it's $20 a shirt. You know, I'm going through all this trouble to make one single t-shirt, it's $20 a shirt. If you order a dozen, I can actually bring that down to 15. If you order, and then, you know, and you bring it down, you work your quantity, you get a discount. And then for your friends and family too. I don't know about you guys. I have people bugging me all the time to make them a t-shirt. I'm like, hey, here's my price. I'll give you the homie discount, 20% off. $20 a shirt, 20% off. I think it comes out to like, it's still $16. So I'm not totally, you know, losing out on doing a favor for a friend. It really helps out. So again, start high. price your full, give everybody the full price, and then give yourself anywhere from 10 to 25% wiggle room from there. And that's how you get your customers. All right, guys, I feel like I've been talking way too much. Again, thank you guys so much for joining me today. It's been an absolute pleasure. Again, and these have been our top five easiest upsells for your small business. There's going to be a blog about this if this video was way too long, which my videos usually are. I talk a lot, all right? There's going to be a short and concise blog on this released within the next week or two. This video is available for replay at heat.press/webinar replay. Okay, well, that's going to do it for me. Thank you guys so much for joining us for this week's My Expert Live Training Webinar. I hope you have an excellent weekend. And prayers going up for all of our friends over there in Texas and all the other iced over states. We really hope all of you guys are staying safe out there. Got friends and family out there. Some of our HPN team here has friends and family out there. So we're, again, sending all of our best wishes and prayers up for all of our pals out there in Texas. If you're watching from Texas, I hope you guys are staying safe. It's going to do it for me, everybody. I hope you have a great rest of your weekend. We'll see you around.